अपने पैर पे कुल्हाड़ी मारना is a Hindi sentence which means taking an axe and hitting it on your own feet. Now you'd be surprised that most often than not, we tend to harm ourselves. Yes, we self-sabotage. By the end of this video, you will know exactly if you have been indulging in self-sabotaging behavior and what you should do to overcome it. So stay tuned. And welcome to another episode of Up It and the Actionables podcast. My name is Payden. If you're new here, welcome. If you're a returning viewer or a listener, thank you for tuning back in. For content that helps you move toward your life goals, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and bell icon to get notified every time we post, which is every Saturday. Now let's get into it. I'm sure you'll agree with me that to stand in your own way of success isn't a smart thing to do or the right thing to do. However, you'd be surprised that it happens all the time. And the crazy bizarre part is it happens without us even realizing it. The psychological definition of self-sabotage is when your own actions hurt you and hold you back from achieving what you really want to achieve. Examples of self-sabotage would be talking negatively with yourself, putting off things that you know that you need to be doing, so procrastinating, excessive use of drugs, consumption of alcohol, even excessive eating, and in the extreme case, causing yourself physical harm. Now, the reason for indulging in self-sabotage could be associated with negative and self-limiting beliefs, which causes one to underestimate their own capabilities and to suppress their feelings, which is a very harmful thing to do. Logically, it would make sense that we do everything in our power to achieve our goals. But that isn't the case because due to self-sabotaging behavior, we sometimes tend to act not in our best self-interest. In fact, we tend to act in the opposite direction. For example, we all know that eating excessively and consuming junk food will not help us stay fit. However, we continue to consume excessive sugar, excessive junk food, and even though this might not seem like a huge thing, it is an act of self-sabotage. Let's say you want to increase your income, but you don't want to sit down and look at your expenses. That again serves as self-sabotage. Choosing to act in a way that does not support you and serve you is an act of self-sabotaging behavior. Before we discuss further on how to identify and fix such self-sabotaging behavior, comment below and let me know if you have noticed personally any behavior that has not helped you, in fact, which has worked against you. In order to identify if you're self-sabotaging, then you need to check your behavior if it is aligned with your goals. Let's explore this further. Irrespective of the goal that you want to pursue for yourself, every pursuit of healthy goals, big and small, requires you to take action. And it becomes simpler to take those actions when our behavior is aligned with the goals that we want to achieve. Our behavior is a result of the actions that we take every single day. It is a pattern that takes some time to grow. The actions that you're taking every day become your long-term behavior. So if you're not happy with the results that you're getting, then the chances are you are self-sabotaging subconsciously without identifying this negative behavior. So if you find yourself not getting the results that you want, then you may want to check your behavior, which is a result of the actions that you are taking or not taking. If you find yourself stuck in a negative pattern, it is time that you may want to start thinking about changing this behavior, which is not serving you. For example, if you find yourself constantly blaming someone, then it is likely that you're repeating actions of not looking internally at your own self, at your own actions, and avoiding taking responsibility. So you may want to check that behavior. So how do you get out of this self-sabotaging behavior? Here's a simple formula that explains it best. So for the goal that you want to achieve, you first have to look at your thoughts. So it is time to assess those thoughts. Next is, what do you do with those thoughts? Meaning, what actions do you take? So your thoughts, your actions, and your long-term behavior will make it simple for you to move toward your goals. So this will show you exactly if what you are doing is moving you toward your goals or not. That's an acid test in itself. If you say you want to achieve something, but your actions are not lining up, then it is simple that your behavior is not in sync, maybe because your thoughts are not in sync, which will cause you to course correct and take the necessary action. So if you say you want to achieve your goals, then you will benefit greatly by checking your behavior, because your behavior is a result of all the repeated actions that you do, which is a direct result of what you think in the first place. So don't decrease your chances of reaching your goals by indulging in self-sabotaging behavior. Now that you know that this self-sabotaging behavior can happen subconsciously, you can become more aware of it and check your behavior. So to help you further, we created a checklist that gives you all the critical steps that you can take in order to pursue your life goals, irrespective of what they may be. So whether it is a career, relationship, health, or even a hobbies goal, check that out. The link is mentioned in the description below. So that's my time. Thank you for watching. If you like this episode, don't forget to like it and share it with a friend. I will see you next week. And don't forget, what you want matters, and it's really up to you to make it happen. Stay healthy, stay safe. See ya.